see in here.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
Oh, that's not going to be true. Does she even know who Nicole is?
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I told you what I know about the picture.
Oh, did you? Oh.
Well, explain the message on the back, ma'am.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
A backhand? The alibi.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? Oh, what an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Let's take a look at that face. And hello, 661995. How's it going? That looks to be truth again. She's making the same face. She only had one lie in the entire case.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
A fan club of me? That's awesome. Thank you. Alright, let's use the telephone.
Grab the phone. R and I could run down an address for Kavanaugh's in no time.
I was just about to think about that.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
Detective.
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thanks.
All right. Let's go to the bar. A soul member. Awesome, Nano. I'll give you a high five for that one. All right, let's get in the car here. Going drinking. Well, not really. All right, let's go.
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. Stranger things have happened.
That's true. Hey! Get out of the way! What are you drinking today? Uh-oh.
All units, off chase help, Major 415, 1624 West 3rd Street, 1624 West 3rd Street. Any unit to handle code 3, identify.
I'll do one of those every now and then, not right now. Shit, man. That's cool. Enjoy your drink. Drink special. I wonder what it is. They should give me a discount. I am the law. I went the wrong way, I think. Hold on. Let me take a look at the map here. Maybe I didn't. It's just a little shortcut. Just get back on the right road. Landmark. Oh yeah, and I forgot to tell you guys. A lot of the landmarks in this game are based on actual landmarks in Hollywood, which is actually pretty good. A pretty cool thing, I would say. Actually, Rooster Teeth did a little video showing actual landscapes in this game in their actual landscapes in real life. They're pretty cool. Alright.
Hey,
you're at the bar.
No, you don't.
God damn it, I know you. No, you don't.
We were at school together. How about you buy me a drink? For old time's sake.
I don't know you. Let me alone. Can I punch him in the face?
Yeah, you and me go way back. Way, way back. Ain't that right?
I don't know you. Who the hell are you? Drunky man. Oh well. Let's go in here.
You looking for someone?
Call these grits?
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
Yeah, I know that. That's what I'm just saying. It's based on, like, actual Los Angeles or L.A. in the 1940s. All right, it's this guy right here. You, Mr. Seth? I'm going to take you to town, you see?
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that.
Oh, no? That's a shame. Well, I'm going to ask you questions, sir. Because you sound very suspicious with this kind of voice.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
This guy is not very believable. That's for sure. He's like, ooh!
You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
All right. Let's see here. Where's the receipt? Was it the train one, or was it... Yeah, I think it's just the train... Or was it this one here? The live hog. Yeah, I would assume that's the one. Let's see here. Well, does it say that on here? No, it doesn't really say. Alright, well, I'm gonna go with that one.
You were there, Morgan. We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you on it.
Alright already. That fool Adrian's fallen for some dame in Seattle. He wanted me to make it look like he'd been attacked.
Alright, I'm gonna ask him for his location now.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
Oh, did he? My face is very serious.
I'm tired of your shtick, Morgan. Spill it, or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of you.
He's holding up at my place. He's waiting for some money to come through before he blows town.
An address?
It's an apartment house at the corner of Temple and Figueroa. Apartment number 2.
I think that's all. Thanks for your help, Morgan. We appreciate it.
Hey, I'm just glad I could help. I love cops.
Cuff him, let him go. It's up to you, Phelps. There's no way I'm writing this idiot up.
One heck of a Sunday. What should we do, guys? Should we arrest this man? Or should we let him go?
I got drinking to do. You're getting nothing more from me.
Punch him in the dick? Well, in court, or when we interrogate him again, we're gonna arrest him. Go downtown, sir. Mr. Go downtown. You can tell that to the jury. Sit down. Shut up. And don't say a damn thing.
You got Morgan's address? Let's get over to his apartment.
Alright. Let him go and chase him. Yeah, he probably would have ran. Probably. If I would have let him go. Alright. Morgan's apartment. We need to go there now. Alright.
I've met some pretty good liars in my time. People who sound convincing because they actually believe their own bullshit. Type is clever. Hard to
Frank Morgan is not one of those people.
No, he is not.
No, he's not indeed. Hot dogs! Damn.
Let's go ahead.
I wanted hot dogs, but I guess I can't. Not human! Hot dogs! Damn.
Roger, KTPL.
Alright. Get out of the way!
People might move out of the way quicker if you use the siren.
Oh, I can use the siren? Yeah! Everybody get out of the way! The law is coming down! Whee! Go fast! Down this empty road. Pigeons! Alright, wait. I think I missed my turn. Got a crazy driver. Cola King. Hold on. First off, no hot dog stands will be allowed to live. Yeah! Oh! That one went flying. Alright, let's go. PM. Well, I just came out of the bar, Kepi.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
Yes. Let's. He's number two.
Apartment two.
Freeman Morgan. His names are backwards. Yes. Crazy taxi.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, not yet though. But you get it. Okay, so number two. Need to go this way. We need to go this way. Where is room? Here he is.
Help you, gentlemen? LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest. Look, I'm really sorry about this. I never tried to hurt anyone. I just needed to get away from LA. I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
Oh, son of a bitch! Oh, he went up here. Get over here!
There's no point running, Adrian.
Where are you going? Paco! Whee! Oh.
Mr. Black, get back here right now.
Yes, Mr. Sir. You get your ass back here. Because your ass is in trouble.
It's over, Adrian.
Oh, he's screwed.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
Yeah!
That turned out to be quite some case, huh? Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you can go a long way in this department.
Yeah. I did it. Agent is Jack the Ripper. Oh yeah, look at that. City damage. Almost $69. We were $1 short. Dang. Should have went for one more hot dog stand. Then it would have been 69. Oh well. Let's continue.
You have any plans for weekend liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection. It had better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. 2-day field drill. Clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished? Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Dun-dun-dun! That foreshadowing. A marriage made in heaven! Oh!
Gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Yeah, the bum took a
slip. All right.
Put him down with my sap.
Let's do it. You can only... I guess you can run in here. But yeah, it's time to do another hit and run. Well, actually, this is our first hit and run case.
Are you drunk, mister?
No. I am not. I am not drunk. You're crazy. Cuckoo crazy. Is this our car?
Can you drive to this
one? Oh, no, no. I want to drive. Let me drive. What the heck? Okay, there we go. No, I am not. Well, maybe right there I was, but I don't know.
Looks like the DA is gonna press charges. Anna Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know.
Yeah. Girl.
She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
I'll convince him to let it go.
How you do that?
I'll give him something better.
And what's that? I guess it isn't this way. Hold on. Back it up. Or actually... Alright. Pretend that didn't happen. Okay, pretend that didn't happen either.
Now look what you've done!
Now look what you've done! Rabble, rabble, rabble.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Vic is a white male named Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar. Her name is Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so? We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
All right. Let's take a look here. How about this hat? Gotta be something. No? Anything? Hello, Mr. Hat. Anything? No? Okay. I guess not.
Well, landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind.
Yes. Alright. Alright. Anything there? Nope. Okay. How? Oh, didn't mean to do that. Huh? What has he got here? Ooh, a wallet.
We can notify next of kin.
All right. We now know his address, and we got money. But it probably doesn't mean anything. Alright. Put that back. Anything on this side? Yes. Another note. What the fuck? Anyways, moving on.
Patterson has life insurance.
Life insurance? Well, he's kinda dead! Alright. Anything on this arm? Nope. Alright. Put that down. What do we got here? More blood. All over that arm. Nope. Doesn't look like anything on that one. Alright. Didn't mean to use that. Put that back. I think we're done with that.
What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I don't know how intoxicated once I'd done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
Yeah, you're right, Rockham. It's just a scratch. I mean, it's just a flesh wound. I mean, look at it. Look at that. That's a flesh wound.
Body traveled a good 20 feet.
20 feet of flesh wound, as you can see. It's common. Got more blood here.
This blood is a long way from the body. The car must have been going like a bat out of hell.
Yeah. Hail! There's one more thing over here.
So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
Hmm. He braked. Interesting. Oh, the trash can over here. I remember about this. When I did play this mission, I found this the first time. Two, in fact. Dun dun dun! That's a bloody knife!
A knife covered in blood.
Could be a steak knife. This is a hit and run case, Phelps. Anyone could have thrown away a kitchen knife.
In any case, we'll want tech services to scrub the alleyway before they bag the knife.
Yes. That must have been a nice throw, though. I mean, this is pretty much how he did it. because if you saw, he hit the guy. He parked, like, right here. He must have a nice arm. That's a nice throw. I will give him that. That was a nice throw. I guess we'll ask her now some questions.
It's all yours, Detective.
Well, thank you.
Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski.
All right, eyewitness report.
Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
An argument, eh? That's a pretty truth face right there. That looks pretty not lying whatsoever there. So I will run with the truth.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
Damn. All right.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
That is as well true. Her face is pretty truth.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
3C8. Interesting.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. Man and a woman. That's all.
Man and a woman. Hey. That's not true. Yeah, that's pretty doubtful. I don't believe you. There was more to this argument.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. Trying to find work as an actress, and things are pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
Yeah.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Give it a rest, Bukowski.
Let's see what the patrons have to say.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
All right, Mr. Bartender. I'll grab that paper afterwards.
I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
It's a hit-and-run incident. Wonder if he knows anything about it. He probably had the best angle of it from where he's standing.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
Oh, yeah, bullshit. Bullshit. That's about a doubt that I ever seen in my life.
So what was he doing outside? It's against licensing regulations to drink on the sidewalk.
Mr. and Lorna were having a fight. The owner made him take it outside. It was pretty ugly.
I don't believe that whatsoever. Going outside with drinks, that's against the rules. Association with the victim.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
That's pretty true. That face is saying the truth. That's pretty true. I will believe him on that one.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
So the wife was here. Okay. So that is all true. There were two people here. Argument overheard in the bar.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
Hmm. He's smiling, though. But he's got that doubt in his eyes.
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy?
Leroy Sabo? The owner?
And hello, Solus. Kappa. How's it going? Alright.
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
Oh, you know. Shut up. You know. I know you know. That is pretty doubtful right there again.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you going to tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm gonna need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
Awesome.
Get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Hmm. Interesting. Let's grab this newspaper here real quickly. Dun-dun-dun.
Courtney! Come in. Have a seat.
Thanks, Doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. If we can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
Dun-dun-dun. All right. Put that down. Got 13 newspapers collected. We almost got 10 away from collecting them all already. That's crazy. Anything over here? Nope. Want to make sure if there's anything in here when it comes to, Let's see, let's try the phone here.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license, registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thank you.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
My goodness. We found it. We know who owns that dying car. Alright. So, I believe that's everything in this place. I don't think we have anything else. So, alright. Let's go into the car here. If I can get in. No! I want to drive. Please? No? I guess it's, we can't pick certain cars. Dang it. What is this? What's it gonna be like, Grand Theft Auto? Fine, I'll take my car. So where should we go first? The Patterson residence or the Shelton residence? Which one would you guys like to see first? I'm not sure if it matters which way you go. Honestly, I don't really know. If it really matters. Shelton? Alright. We'll go over there. It does matter. Oh, it does matter? Okay. Then we'll go there first. Alright.
Lucky break getting the partial ID. These cases are usually dead in the water after 24 hours if no one comes forward.
Why don't they just stop?
You heard about fight or flight during the war?
Sure. Never back your enemy into a corner. That kind of stuff.
Right. Well, in a hit and run, the perp is already in flight. It's easier to keep going. It takes a degree of moral courage to stop and accept responsibility.
You're not as dumb as you make yourself out to be, are you, Stefan?
I didn't know I was making myself out to be dumb.
Plane is 211 in progress at 933 South Broadway. Any center unit able to handle identified?
Nope. Not helping. Oh, okay. His head's going through the roof. 10 points if you hit the trash can. Oh, I see. Ah, he's trying to make a run for it. He's trying to get out of town. And you can tell he hit him.
That's the son of a bitch right there. William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene. Not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
Oh, God damn it! Oh, it's a car chase. Let's get him!
That coward thinks he can run from everything.
Get over here, you son of a bitch! Woo! We're gonna get him. Until we hit the tree. Alright. We'll get him, though. Where is he? Oh my god, tripped on this thing. Alright. Help us get him! Alright, here we go. He's on site. I see him.
You! Whoa, wrong person!
Come on!
No! That's the wrong person!
I wonder if he can't
Hi-ya!
Driving like this.
Uh-oh. Oh, hold on. Come here.
Don't let that asshole get away. Enough game.
Hi-ya!
Let's take this guy out.
Oh, come on now. And hello, tall guy. How's it going? Come here! Oh, what are you talking about? Alright, here we go. Oh, watch out, civilian. Oh man, this guy put up a fight. Oh, he's taking out traffic signs. Get out of the way. Oh, he's going to church or something. I don't know.
Uh-oh. Get after him.
He's running. He's running.
Hold it right there, Shelton.
Where's he going?
It's a vehicular manslaughter rap sound, Shelton.
I hit him. I admit it, I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Why didn't you stop?
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about the manslaughter charge.
That's the best line in the game so far.
Paperwork. Procedure can wait. Probably go speak to the wife and let her know what's happening.
Okay. You become all heart at the prospect of paperwork, don't you?
That was the best line in this game so far. Shut up! I am the law. Alright. Now, for the Pedersen residents. And who heard about the news this week? Monday night, or Monday I should say, Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag gets premiered. I am excited. Alright. Another landscape. Oh. Sorry. Yeah, it is a pirate. It does have to do with pirates. And I loved the pirate ship battles in AC3. So I'm excited about they bring back more pirates. And oh, goodness! God dang it! Get out of my way! Alright. But I don't expect the game to be out till like 2014, though. It's what they say it's gonna be out in 2014. Q1 2014 is what they say. Oh god, look out! Oh my goodness. Alright. Now, let's just go ahead here. Though it does seem kind of early to already announce AC4, I am still pretty excited about the new AC. I am a big fan of the franchise. The trailer premieres Monday, so definitely check AssassinsCreed.com for the premiere of Black Flag, or it might be on YouTube. Whichever. March 4th, yes. Which is indeed a Monday. Alright, and Tuesday, Tomb Raider's out. I want that game.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Pattison.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
All right, ma'am.
Can you tell me what happened?
What's to tell? He got hit by a car and now he's dead.
You don't appear to be too upset about the fact.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick it out this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I beg your pardon? You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Pattison's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Pattison, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No. I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
Damn, what a bitch. Hello, failing gamer. How's it going? Yeah, this game's pretty good. so far. It is my first playthrough of the game. So far, it's been pretty fun. Alright. She was at the hit-and-run incident. Let's ask her a few questions.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
Oh! Was that how it happened? Your eyes really tell the story there. You're doing good? Awesome. That's good to hear. I'm doing not too bad myself. Alright. That's pretty doubtful, woman.
You expect me to believe that, Morgan? It's all very convenient.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. Kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. All right. The nature of argument. What were you arguing about, Mom?
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk.
We were always arguing. So what?
You know. That's another dope.
Admit it. You were baiting him, pushing his buttons. We can easily get the full story from the regulars in the bar.
All right. Lester was playing cards out back. He lost, of course, and wanted back in. He suggested I earn the money on my back to get a mistake. That was the proposition he was putting to his so-called buddies. So maybe I was a little angrier than usual. Let's just say I took exception to his idea.
The bartender said that you and Leroy were planning to go into business together. Can you explain how you'll get the money to do that?
I have a little money saved away.
Oh, you do? Well, from what I've been told, you've lost all your money.
You're being economical with the truth, Lorna.
You want to back that up, little man?
Little man? Well, he has life insurance, which I believe is this one right here, on the letter.
You increased the premium on Lester's life insurance. GI insurance policies have a $10,000 payout.
It was Leroy's idea. Lester lived on the edge. He was always getting into fights, crap games, pinochle, you name it. Turns out it was good advice.
It speaks to motive and premeditation, Lorna.
You're forgetting the hit-and-run detective.
You and Mr. Sabo have an interesting day.
I'm sure we will, officer. Now, if you could both just leave.
We're leaving, ma'am. Sorry for your loss. I can see what a tough time you're having with all this.
Yeah. I heard the later interrogations get a lot tougher. The early ones are not too bad, but soon they'll like throw a difficulty spike in them. Which is pretty cool, I guess. Alright. Yes, I hope they do have an interesting day. Oh, hold on. Let's go to the phone real quickly. I forgot about that. It's probably something we need to call for. Let's see here. Your body's ready? Awesome.
Phelps badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Messages, please.
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Patterson autopsy.
Thanks for your help.
All right.
That's the guy from the papers.
Prepare yourself. Yeah. I heard they get pretty tough. It's hard to read faces in the later ones. What? Who's honking at me? Oh, it wasn't me.
You can drive.
No, you can't.
Do we know where we're going?
Yes, we do. I am driving, sir. Alright. Wanna go here. And oh god, there's a lot of cars. Oh jeez. Alright. Good thing for the autosaves in this game. Alright, let's see. Doo doo doo. slow it down here. Get around this guy. There we go. So how's everyone doing this evening? I haven't really asked that to everyone. So how's everyone doing on this Friday night? I'm not gonna do that. God damn it! I knew he would do that too. Yeah, it really is Infinity. Awesome, awesome. Good to hear see everyone's doing pretty good. Yeah, it worked. That's a naughty tall guy. Naughty, naughty. I'm just kidding. You got a new game? What game, Mickey? Ooh, do we get to see a dead body?
Done.
It's a dead body.
We can put the driver in front of a judge in less than a week. You'd be making a big mistake. Run that by me again? The victim was dead before the car hit him. Two puncture wounds to the right side of the thorax. Second puncture reached his heart. You're kidding me. Been doing this job 23 years, son. No one's ever laughed at one of my jokes. He was stabbed to death? Long, sharp knife. Length of a bayonet. We found a knife in the alleyway. Where is it now? Was it bagged? By Patrolman Kaplan. Perfect. I'll get you a definite match.
Jesus, we got him. Murder one. We were right there, and they tried to stare us down. Now they'll both get the gas chamber.
The gas chamber.
We have the knife, we have the coroner's report, and I bet we could roll Sabo as a witness. Let's bring her in.
Yeah. Someone's going downtown. We'll end with you. I heard that's a really good game. From a lot of people. Alright, someone's going downtown.
You know the way. You can drive.
Back to the residence.
Where are we headed?
Whoa! Excuse me! Mr. Truck, please! You almost hit me. I am the law. What are you doing? Alright, let me get back in here. What's up, Meg? What the hell? That guy almost hit me. He's going downtown for sure. Oh, excuse me. Alright. I know. I just noticed I almost did too. And that's what happens when you let your partner drive. You get hit in the face by a car. I almost died there today. Alright. I am the law! Hold on.
Slow down, you idiot.
Gotta take out the hot dog stand. For 10 points? Success.
Slow down before someone gets hurt!
Sorry. I just can't look at hot dog stands. They killed my father. Anyways, let's keep going this way. That should be a backstory in this game. Cole's father died because of a hot dog stand. That's why I must take him out. Yes. Alright. So we're back here again.
Spoken to the coroner, Mrs. Patterson. He confirmed your husband's cause of death. We'd like you to come downtown and answer some questions.
It wasn't me. It was Leroy's idea. Leroy stabbed him. I had nothing to do with it.
Where is Leroy now?
He's in the bedroom.
You're very good, Lorna.
Put the gun down, Leroy. If you do something stupid now, you don't stand a chance in front of the grand jury.
Nice of you to give me up, sweetheart. All that whispering in my ear, telling me how we had to get rid of him, how good it could be, all the money we could claim, all that planning.
how to get him into the street, how to make it look like an accident.
For God's sake, Leroy, shut up.
You have all the bases covered, baby.
I have nothing to do
you
with it.
You think I'm going to fry for you,
he's
Lorna?
He's a crazy man. Shoot him. Shoot him, for God's sake.
Oh, no.
It's too late.
Oh, he's going to get it. Get over here. You're going to die, sir. You're going to get it. Whoa. Traffic. Come here. This guy's a fast runner. Go get you, sir. Yeah, I'll shoot you, sir. Oh, he's getting away. Yeah, indeed, he did. I am the law. Uh-oh, he's gonna kill another innocent civilian.
Now, are we gonna make a bargain or what? How long do you think you can hold out?
Yeah, sir. What are you gonna do?
You wanna back off right now.
Help me!
He is dead.
You look spooked, Phelps. I thought you'd been under fire before.
It never gets any easier, Bukowski.
Nice shot. Well, Red Dead has taught me well. Those headshots work all the time.
So, I give you a hit and run, you bring me back fraud, conspiracy, and first-degree murder. This is how a good detective operates, Phelps. You take nothing at face value. You keep digging and asking questions until you get to the truth. You got some sharp elbows on you, detective. I like that. Keep up the good work.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, that vehicle damage, and that city damage. Oh well, I am the law. But I'll be right back before I do this next mission. I'm actually just going to go take a quick little break. So, more LA Noir in just a minute here. But for now, here is intermission.
Welcome to intermission. Intermission. Welcome to intermission. Yeah, intermission.
More L.A. Noir. So, let's continue. Yeah, it is an octopus. Well, no, not really.
My family runs a shipping business in San Francisco. We used to have two ships a week to Tokyo. We've been in shipping for two generations, Hank. I've never been on a voyage anywhere.
feel like Odysseus in the beginning of his journey.
The Odyssey took 10 years, Cole.
This is the American century. America can rule the world after we win this war.
We need to stay alive, Cole. These men are counting on us. Have you heard what the veterans are saying to each other?
No.
Golden Gate in 48. That's 4 more hard years of fighting.
More flashbacks. I'm on Idol. Dead or alive. Oh, wait, too soon.
Bukowski, you have a new case. 2 women, possible drink drive.
How was that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Well, that's easy. That's like a little walk. Can I see it out the window?
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too
hard. I want to
see. Look at you bantering with the boys.
Yeah, you can. It's right there. This one's really sick.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Well, I'll try not to gag. Anyways, let's move on here. But again, welcome everyone who are here. Watching some LA Noir. Hope you're all enjoying the stream tonight.
Whoa! Easy!
Whoa! Didn't realize going downstairs was such a hardcore sport. Oh. Alright. Can we walk there, or... I think it could use a little driving. Alright. Wait for it here. Whoa. Wait for it. Whoa! That guy's crazy. That was like a crazy turn right there. Alright. Very nice. I'll be crazy too.
We might get there quicker if we use the siren.
The sidewalk. Is it not like right here? It should be. Yeah, this game has DLC. And I'm actually gonna buy it later this week. If I do pick up,
just ahead.
Tomb Raider this week, which I probably will. I'll probably, buy Microsoft points to put towards DLC for this game.
Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard, Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy McAfee. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight. What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passenger's a Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. She's pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. She cuts rough.
All right.
Out of the way, Bob.
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
Oh, okay. So how do we get down there? Let's see. Gotta be a way. Maybe it's around. Let's see. Should probably check out the crime scene before we do anything. I'd say. Oh, it's over there. Okay, I see. just didn't, couldn't see the pathway. But there must be a way down over here now. Yeah, I know. I was just looking. Okay, here it is. That's Siren. Alright. Take a look at this crime scene.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Oh? What is? Let's take a look inside here. Ooh.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
That's pretty head concussion-like. What do we got here? Panties! Oh, they're ripped. What the hell?
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag.
What?
I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
Semen? Graves. Let's take a look here. What do we have here? A letter.
She's a long way from home.
She writing a letter to running away from home? Interesting. 1950s. Where you can drink beer, smoke a cig, and sign. Pretty much. Pretty much, Hunt. Alright. Got the... license plate. It should be a clue. No? I don't know. It should be. You'd think it would be a clue. Who knows? Weird. You'd think it would be a clue. But, guess not. Take a look at a better side here. That blood! All over. Well, not really a lot of it. Not like that last mission. Or that mission... Two missions ago, I should say. Or cases. In this case. Oh, see what I did there? Alright.
Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
Ooh, let's see. Oh, what do we got here?
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
Oh my. Interesting.
Another day.
Well, actually, yes, you're right. The game is actually acted, if you can really say that. They actually had a bunch of cameras.
How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff?
Oh, hold on.
If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
Yeah. But anyways, this game is acted more than, like, read out. They actually had cameras on all the actors in this game. There's, like, a bunch of cameras around their face, pretty much detailing their entire face with their motions and everything like that. That's, like, one of the first times, or like one of the first games that ever did that, if I'm correct. And it paid off pretty well here. Very realistic. Yeah, motion cap. Yes. I think I got everything. Or what's that guy doing over there? He's looking at something over there. Yeah, it is pretty awesome. I must agree on. I don't know if that's everything, actually. I feel like there's something else, too, but I may be wrong. But I think I got everything. Oh, you see a body? Well, I know I was supposed to talk to a lady. I'm just thinking if I missed anything else to look around for. But all right.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep
it. Oh. Oh. Mrs. Ballard, are you seducing me? Oh. All right. Anyways, let's ask some questions.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn.
Huh? It was me!
It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
Hello, Kreutz. How's it going? I didn't actually pay attention. I was doing a Mickey voice, but... Okay.
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady.
Oh.
And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
I'm doing not too bad. Thank you very much. Glad you could be here. Let's ask her about the injured female passenger.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
Hmm. That looks either... Truth? No, not truth. Looks either doubt or lie. Panties! Oh, God. Yeah, she is coming on to me. For a 40-year-old. Told you. Whoever said all the cougars come after me, there you go. But anyways, she's lying.
I think you're lying, Mrs. McAfee. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Yes. Panties!
Miss Hamilton's underwear were physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
Oh? The truth is in the panties. Ew. That's doubtful.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
Okay.
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement... You just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
Why are you being so doubtful? But that time it feels true, though. That's a hard face to read. It's like it's saying truth, but again, it's saying dope. I'll go with dope.
I want to know what happened between you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it. And this is where I end up.
Mrs. McCaffey, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news house.
Mrs. McCaffey, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
A heel?
I think we're good here.
I am not a villain.
Shake out of the kid.
Wait a minute, this isn't wrestling. I'm not a shoe. Anyways, moving on.
Officer, please tell me.
Yes, he is a face. That face legitimately says he's a good guy. Because he's the law. Alright, let's get in the car here. Let's go to the hospital.
KGPL to car 11K, 11 King. The car crash victim has regained consciousness at Central Receiving Hospital.
Ooh, let's get there then.
11K Roger, en route.
Tree! Yes, a baby face. That's the good of good guys. Right there. Alright. Oh, that's the end of the road? What the hell? They would do something like that. Back it up. Hold on. Slow and steady now. There we go. Alright. Let's see here. What's with the... There's like no roads. My goodness. Hello, Zeppo. Pingus indeed. How's it going? Crumpets and Pincus. I mean, what? That doesn't sound right. Whoa!
Take it easy.
And not a single scratch. Alright, where's the hospital? Right here. I don't know what happens if you fail a mission. You regret it? I regret it. Because I failed a mission. I regret it.
Hello, Detective Phelps. Here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room right behind you, Detective.
Why, thank you very much.
You can't hold me here. No, I don't need to be manhandled by a doctor. I need my lawyer. Hey! Where is the telephone? Do you know who I am?
What? What is going on? Someone's a little cuckoo.
Hello, Doctor. I'm Detective Phelps. You're attending to the young lady from the auto accident?
Yes. She's conscious now, but I doubt she'll remember much. She's still feeling some of the after effects.
Jessica was drugged?
She certainly was. Chloral hydrate would be my guess, and there's clear evidence of abuse. She's still a minor, Detective.
Someone planned a double murder to cover up a statutory rape? Swap 7 years for life and gets Guy McCaffey on their case?
Ew.
Doesn't make much sense to me.
I guess it depends on what they had to lose.
Rape. That's not funny. All right.
Feeling better since this morning, Jessica?
A little. My head still feels swimmy.
All right. I'm actually going to see if there's anything in here. Real quickly.
Optimistic, Cole.
Yes. Jessica Day? Maybe.
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. But it's not bad to be just a check. It's got you a good thing to check before you interrogate. Oh, you can't look at that. Okay.
Oh. You're making me uncomfortable. Just standing around here looking at me, not saying anything.
Not sure.
I'm looking for stuff. Mystic Tales. Alright. I think that's everything. Let's ask you some questions.
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
All right. Crash incident report.
Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Nothing happened yesterday. Oh. That's pretty much a lie. Something happened.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
Oh, really? Then why was your underwear ripped from your pants?
We found your underwear in your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up. That was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage.
Yeah, she's 15. That's some fucked up shit. I wonder if she has any contact with her parents.
We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah. I don't believe that at all. She's lying again. I know she is. Yeah, you and Meg know she's lying.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, detective, why would I lie to you?
You lied before, so it's easier you're lying to me. Because you have a letter from Mother. I know it. I know that's the one. So, hopefully this goes through, works. Yep.
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
Okay. That's more doubtful than lying this time.
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. McAfee? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment?
I overheard Junie speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Junie. But they seemed okay yesterday, like they worked it out.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
That one looks more truth. That's more innocent than I would say. From all the other faces she's made, that's more true.
Jessica, I really need you to help me here.
I remember the mermaid.
Was it the mermaid in the movie too?
No, it was on the front of a building. We pulled up in front of the mermaid.
Thank you, Jessica. You've been a big help. Here's my card. If you think of anything or you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
Well, that sucks for you, then.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her.
Uh-oh.
There she goes. Come on.
Yeah, indeed. Poor girl, indeed. All right. We're tailgating her. You see? All right. She's going this way. I'll take out stuff.
That would be a bad time to forget how to drive, Cole.
I'm sorry. Yes, hey.
Ballard is definitely.
Yeah, I was in the way. Whoa. Yeah, you don't want to get too close. We are tailgating them. We don't want them to know we're near them.
She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
Yeah. She seems to know how to drive perfectly now. Interesting. Excuse me.
Oh. That too close?
No, it wasn't too close. That was fine. I guess she wasn't driving.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Right. Alright. Let's go inside. We need to eavesdrop what she's doing. What? How? How did I get spotted? It told me to go to the newspaper. So I did. And now it tells me no. Hold on.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Let's see. Was she looking around? I didn't even see. Hold on, let's see. Oh, take cover by the door. Okay, I see. Alright. Go on the phone. There we go.
No! I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want. Well, then make someone else do it! You still know people out here, don't you? Then make some calls! I'm gonna be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803. Sure, I got the film.
Interesting. Wait till she gets out of the building. Or wait till she leaves the premise. Alright. We're good now. See if there's any newspapers in here to collect. Looks like there isn't. Alright. We know where to go now. Ha 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 ha. Alright.
So what's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy McAfee's wife in the first place. Or he'd done the job properly. McAfee will break a fella's legs just for looking at his brother.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story?
I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
Yeah. Gotta hurry now.
So if Ballard was doing someone a favor, why did they try to kill her?
That's a good question. No! I am not helping you. This is important.
All units in the vicinity and call
progress at apartment 803, Wilson's apartment hotel.
Get out of the dang way. Oh, no.
11K code 3, all other units code 2. KGPL clear.
Get out of the way.
Gun it. Get to the apartment before someone gets hurt.
I'm going. Just people are in the goddamn way. Traffic is bad here in Los Angeles. Or Hollywoodland. Alright, we've made it. He's going down.
You the cops? I tried to stop them. It's room 803, left out of the elevator.
Alright. Let's go up. Do-do-do-do-do.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
Yeah, it'd be them clicking. Alright, so it was 803.
Give it up! LAPD!
Oh! It's a flight! Oh! Here we go! Wanna fight? Oh! To the ground! Yay! Oh! Here we go! And welcome back, Seppo! Throw him into the building! Oh, Falcon knee. That's a KO. And Smash Bros. Has taught me well. Use the Falcon knee! It's a one-hit KO, pretty much.
Are you injured, Mrs. Bishop?
I'm all right now. Those horrible, awful men.
Perhaps you should sit down, ma'am.
Yes. Forgive me, officers. I'm very flushed. I'll just sit down for a moment.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am. Take a moment while we look around.
Yes, I am cool. I am pissed because they took my hat off. Rubble. All right.
This doesn't pertain to the case.
No. It does not. Hello, 12.8. How's it going? All right. Let's take a look here. Ooh, what we got here? All right.
I don't think this is going to help us.
Nope. All right. Let's see. Do we have anything in here? Got a cup.
Incidental.
Yeah, I don't think so. Daisy? Anything here? Guess you can't go in that door. Should be able to put my hat back on. Where's my hat? Oh, there's my hat. Ah, there you go. Now, style and profile. Once again. Got a broken vase. Or not.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
Nope. What about this?
Junk.
Yeah. Alright. Let's see. Anything around here? Nope. I guess. Let's go in the room here. Here we are. That's swag indeed.
Not much help.
Maybe, this.
I doubt it.
Nope. I assume it's one of these things. It's probably the brush.
Seems irrelevant.
No? There's something in this room. I know there is. Bingo.
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
Yeah. Wish I made that much money. Alright.
not everything here is going to be relevant.
Nope. But still a good thing to check everything. Though I do check everything. To make sure I get the case. Oh, what's this? Gay cowboys.
Presented to Mark.
What was he in? Brokeback Mountain? Alright, let's see here. Oh, there was something here. Money.
No good to me.
No? Alright. Oh, hold on, there's more down here. What we got here?
This isn't what we're looking for.
No. I guess that's it for that. There's something here.
Great Wall of Babylon. A replica of a replica.
Okay. What do we got here? A picture.
Looks like the old movie set downtown.
Very interesting. Anything else? Oh, there's something right here. What do we got here?
Don't think this is anything.
Nope. Okay. How about this?
Nothing significant.
Okay. Ooh, is that something? Nope. Oh, okay, I thought I was stuck for a minute there. Not sure if that's everything. It seems about I got everything. Don't know if that's everything for sure though, but should be another picture. Alright, I'll take a look. Oh, that's just that. Where the lady is? Oh, okay. Where the lady is? Hello, lady. Oh, right here.
Looks like we found our mermaid. Who are these men in the picture?
My husband, Mark, and Marlon Hopgood. They work together on occasion. That's Hopgood's shop.
Okay. And I think that's everything. Let's check a look out here just in case. Alright, nothing. Alright. Let's ask her some questions. Oh. There we go. Alright.
Those men, I think they work for Guy McAfee. Do you know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McAfee. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McAfee alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
Oh, he doesn't, does he? I don't know, that seems pretty doubtful.
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
That's pretty true. I believe that. She is blinking a lot. That's for sure. But that's, I'd say that's true.
Either we find him, or McAfee's people do, Mrs. Bishop. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find.
Oh, hold on. Okay.
You care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Alright, ooh, we got a prop store. And what about the check?
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
I think I'd be sure. It said on the freaking check. So, I would say that'd be a lie.
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, Detective?
Sure. Let's see here. Let's see. Check for 2009 until Lauren O'Hop. Okay, let's see for something about Lauren on here. Anything else? It might be just the check then. Alright. That's just the check then.
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McAfee?
Lorna works at a check-cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
Picture's been cast? Hmm. That's a doubtful face. He's like,
Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, Detective. Are you sure you really want to know? The truth is, my husband likes them young.
Ew!
You think that's okay?
I know where this is going.
I was 16 when I first met him. I thought he was a genius, a magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Oh, does it now?
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, Detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
She's moody. Let's use the phone real quickly.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247. I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thanks, ma'am.
All right. Let's go there. Shall we? All right. Let's go down the elevator. Jeez, that was a loud elevator.
An aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, a movie producer's wife, and finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous.
And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act.
And hello, Ep. How's it going? Alright. Doo-doo-doo. Let's run to our car. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Alright. We want to go here.
Mrs. Bishop knows more than she's letting on.
She doesn't seem to realize how much trouble her husband is in. The LAPD are the least of their worries right now.
You think she'd have gotten the hint after those hatchet men redecorated her apartment?
Maybe she's just loyal.
Or she's in on it. She didn't seem like your average giddy broad with nothing between the ears.
Well, she might just be trying to buy enough time for Bishop to put a couple of oceans between him and McCaffrey.
Any sentry into the 415 possible
mental case? No, not helping. I am doing the case, you see? Well, I didn't really have a choice on the matter. And it wasn't me, you see?
Do-do-do.
Alright. Keep heading this way. I'll actually go down this way. Wow, wow, wowie. Hold on. Wow. Well, I thought they were gonna hit each other. Right there. Alright. Here it is, I believe. Whoops.
I wouldn't feel safe in a tank with you driving.
Oh, I'm sorry. Alright. There's the mermaid. Ariel, you slut! Alright. Let's see here. A bear. Grizzly bear.
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We're investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
How'd you hear about that? I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way.
It's getting interesting. Yes, I do have a pull-up. If someone can post it for me, that would be very nice. That would be awesome. Thank you, Kippy. What do we have here?
Keep him here, Stefan. I'm going to take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
Yeah, knucklehead. Let's take a look. Guess we can't go in that one. I'm going to take a look around in this area. Where's Happy Wars? Well, we played that game for like 2 weeks in a row now. I give it a little break this week. Ooh, what do we got here? Anything? No? I don't know. Do you speak English? Nope. Alright. Hello, Colby. How's it going? I guess nothing. Alright. Let's see here. Maybe this one. This seems about right. Good? Awesome. That's good to hear.
So this is where you sprang from.
Yes. These models come from her. It's the same one. Whoa. Hold on. I guess it doesn't matter. Okay. Ooh, newspaper. I will do that real quickly. Okay, I'll check the studio after this.
Listen, I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up. I hear you're back at school learning to be a doctor, kid. Yes. That's right, Mr. Cullen. So you want to be a doctor and a dope peddler. Interesting combination, huh? Do we have a problem, Mr. Cullen? We might have. Yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying wholesale, so to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice without a little of the middleman taking his cut.
Lenny promised that wouldn't happen, Mr. Cullen. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Let me think. Oh, yeah, he's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. And how can you make a cake with those ingredients, huh? Please.
So how is that my problem, Mr. Cullen?
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dinky little cardboard boxes and...
Surettes.
Yeah, surettes. Great. We can put it into a big vat so we can water it down a little bit.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work that way. You're likely to kill even more people.
Okay, listen. We want to buy you out, kid. I'll offer you $50,000. Hey. Hey! You don't like my offer? Sheldon kid? I think I want him dead.
Dun dun dun! Alright. Someone's gonna die in the newspapers. Alright. Put that down. Let's see here. Are these still the same thing? I think so. I don't think these really matter. Whoops. I knocked over a bucket. How about the trash can? Or the bin, I guess. Whoops. And this is just back in here, isn't it? Well, I guess I can quickly take a look here. Spartan helmets. Interesting. I don't think there would be anything in here. I don't know. You'd think there would be something in here. I guess not. I guess. That's not part of it. Let's go in here then. What's in here? Then. Huh. What are these?
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Doping. So far, you're 0 for 1, Mr. Bad Guy.
Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that? Humor him.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Uh-oh. There is.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company. Can't be that way, Phelps. You couldn't fit a rat through there.
There's something in here. What have we got here? That brush. I thought there would be something on here. On that brush. How about here? No? Okay. Anything here? Should be. Come on. What's this?
Nothing significant.
Nope. Okay. How about in the clothes? Nope. Alright, what's going on here? It's a toilet. And Mia. Alright. seems legit. But how did we get into that room? Is the thing. Because there is a room back there. I know you can go in there. Outside? Alright. Let's see here. Oh, what's this? I feel bullshit. Yep. Yep. It is indeed bullshit. What we got in here? Beer! Nah, it's nothing important. Alright. What is in this room? What's this film?
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
What about the sword? Does the sword do anything, or is it just there? Oh yeah, it's just there. Alright. What do we got here? What's inside?
Well, what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test?
It's gone! Uh-oh. It ain't there! That's no good. Oh, it's alcohol. Nope. Let's see. Okay.
I wonder if they saw this, how many budding starlets would still get on the bus to come to Hollywood.
There are pictures all over the wall of girls posing. Not sure if there's anything else. I'd assume that'd be it, unless I'm supposed to look at something in here. There, I don't see anything. Probably not. I have a gut feeling there is something else in here. But what could it be? I already have that. I have that. Ooh, what's this? It's the washroom. Okay. Alright, I think I got everything in there. And hello, Master Chris. How's it going? I found everything? Oh, okay. So if the music goes down. Okay. Alright, that's a tip for life. Alright, sir. I have found everything. But just to make sure, I didn't actually look at that hole in here. So I'm actually gonna see if that does anything. I don't think it really matters anymore. Alright. But anyways, let's do this.
You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop is doing work for a studio, yes.
When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production, though. I haven't seen him around here in a while.
Oh, have you not? This guy's a lion. I know for sure. Doing not too bad. Awesome, awesome. But yeah, that's pretty lying right there.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here, and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant, and now you start throwing your weight around?